Stop it. Stop it. You're both pretty. Damn it, Lelon. He had a hysterectomy back in the 30s. We've all been through. Oh, hold on. Hi, kids. How are you? Oh, my God. Fix this.
Here it is. Hi. How are you? Gorgeous. Welcome to Billy's World, where all things are possible, except a pure soul. Can you hear the beeping of the microwave? Mimi's inside making pizza bites. Why we invited an Asian here? Which one? This? I don't know. Which, pick your fucking camera already. Ugh. Mimi's inside making pizza bites. And boy, am I angry. Asian angry. Because Mimi's Asian. Well, she's actually Korean. Who knows what she is? We found her in a dumpster. Listen, welcome to Billy's World, where we get into all sorts of wonderful topics, some wonderful guests with BFF, and other shows that I don't remember the names of because, of course, I forget. Because why? I drink. Good for you. Thank you. Let's see what's coming up next on this show. Opening my hand to watch a flame shoot out of it. Witchcraft. Hi, kids. Billy and Francesca here for Twitter Me This, where you, boom, you all Twitter me questions and I'll answer them for you because I'm like a guru. Is that racism? It's not. Guru is an Indian term for someone who's really smart. You're welcome. I know everything. All right. Our first question this week comes in from Hollywood Asked. Oh, Hollywood Assistant. Sorry about it, honey. I didn't know. Hollywood Ass says, what do you think about Ellen and Portia expecting a baby? I didn't know they were expecting a baby. Who shoved it down that crevice? I'm kidding, that's inappropriate. I believe babies are a wonderful addition to any family. And if you're having problems in the relationship, even better. It'll only make you guys stronger. That's the international symbol for stronger. It's further apart. It brings two people closer together. It doesn't. Our next person on Twitter is Dirty Pill Popper. Oh my God, call me. Fine. I am me. Private message me. Whatever you have, I want some. Is it true I can't get an auto refill on my Vicodin prescription anymore? You can't, babe. Listen, forging a doctor's signature on a prescription pad is a real no-no, unless you're really good at it. And if you are, call me, private MME. I swear to God, we'll hook something up. We got something that's going. All right. Coming up next is, at Happy to Be Gay, who isn't, how does one become a drag queen? Good question. The first thing you have to do is have no dreams at all. You have to literally have failed at everything else around you. That includes working at Soup Plantation. And then once you do that, you're on your way to a happier, not so much healthier, you. All right, let's see. At Jenna244 in Orange County, she asked, a guy broke up with me because I am loose. Oh, man, what does that mean? I have two words for you, Jen. Is it Jen? It is. Oh, it's Jenna. Sorry, I'm not wearing my glasses. I should have worn my glasses. I think they're in the other room in a basket under my table. We'll wait. So hard to find good help these days. That's much better. Let's see. Sorry, at Jenna24. A guy broke up with me because I am loose. What does that mean? I have two words for you, Jenna. Drawstring. I think he means you're not doing your coigles, kegels. Coigles, kegels. I'm not sure what the word is, dear. You need to start doing vaginal exercises. And then your body will be so much tighter, so when he... And then you... And then things will be better for, apparently, your next boyfriend. And darling, don't let everyone go down there. No one likes throwing a hot dog down a hallway. Martin Bull. Chocolate or vanilla? Honey. Both. Okay, let's see. I'm gonna butcher this name, and for that, I truly apologize. We have at Shangelikloa. I'm sorry, dear, I'm white. I'm so sorry. I'm not saying you're black, but. At Shangelica Sharon. Is quinceañera only for Latinas, or can I have one? My darling, you can have one for yourself. It's a rite of passage when a young Latin girl turns 15 and becomes a woman. I had one 2 weeks ago, and I'm very close to 15 years old. Cat ears. Curious Jeff. Ooh, is that like Curious George? I love monkeys. I really don't. They're filthy. They throw poop. All right, let's see what Curious Jeff says. I wonder, is your broom? No, hold on. There it is. I wonder, is your boom operator Chinese or Japanese? That's a great question, Jeff, and good for you for knowing the difference. Most white people don't even care. She's actually Japanese and Cantonese, Lilan Matsumoto. Her last name is Japanese, but she spent a lot of time in Canton. This is why she's Cantonese. Yes, I don't know. What am I, a map? All right, let's see. How much sleep is considered a beauty sleep? You're asking the wrong person. I'm a monster. But I do sleep for at least like 9 hours a night, or I'm completely worthless the next day. And guess what? I am worthless the next day either way. I mean, sleep as much as you want, dear. But if you are going to bed drunk, and I know a lot of you are, take an aspirin. You'll thank me the next morning. A lot of people do. Oh, kids, that's our episode of Twitter Me This. Listen, if you Twitter me and follow me and Twitter my Twitter, is it called Twitter? Am I using the word correctly? I am. Twitter me on Twitter and ask me all sorts of questions, and then you, too, might wind up being one of my questions of the week. I'm sure you know the social event of the Halloween season. That's right, Halloweeny is coming up, and I have the two darling lovers who thought the whole thing up. Kids, welcome our first guests. Hi, boys.
Hey, how
welcome,
you doing?
Kids. Welcome, Fred and Jason, to our beautiful little stage.
Thanks
here
for
today.
Having us.
Jesus, I didn't know we were coming to Pee Wee's Playhouse.
Okay, that's it. Well, I stole a lot of stuff.
I would have dressed a little
so
more
okay.
Laid down.
We all have our cocktails because no one
we
works
like
sober.
Cocktails.
So, right now, we get thirsty. Thank you for being our first guest of our new winter
season.
We're
truly honored, yeah.
Here at BFFs, we're just getting warmed up. Halloween is coming up.
Yes,
it is.
And of course, the whole town is buzzing about it. It's a social event of the season. Nice. But for you kids out there in the world who don't live in Los Angeles, who do live in Los Angeles and live under a rock, people in Silver Lake, I want you to tell the kids about how did Halloween get started?
Pretty much we both, prior to meeting, just loved Halloween. We always had our own independent Halloween parties.
We decided, like, let's have a Halloween party. Let's throw, you know, invite a few friends over at our house.
At the house.
We're going to throw a party. Yeah. We're going to go Costco, grab a bunch of booze, and invite
our friends over.
The last minute, we made a decision because we just became involved with the LA Gay and Lesbian Center. We decided that last, you know, day or so beforehand, like, hey, bring $15, whatever we bring in, we'll donate the thing.
Which is beautiful.
We made like $30,000 for the center.
Right.
We
all had, for fundraising.
Yeah.
Kids.
And we had sponsors.
Didn't take a penny.
Right.
Didn't take a penny.
Which is so beautiful because I'll do fundraising stuff. Not that you ever asked me to host. I'm not angry about it. No, it's fine. I don't know. You don't want me there. Because
never had a host.
Because you know I steal things from houses.
We've never had a host, but. Costumes are out of this world. I mean, they literally spend every waking moment.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, I'm sure there are a bunch of people, like the WeHo bars are suffering tonight.
Since our house, we've had to move it out of our house. We moved to the cemetery, the Hollywood Forever Cemetery.
Right.
That venue in that year put us on the map.
I love that it's gotten so big and everyone enjoys it and it helps the community and it really, it brings people together because it's a nice thing. You know what I mean? There's so many people who do things for their own whatever grandeur, but you guys love doing it.
And we're all, as gay men, we're all kind of creative, whether it's an outfit.
Stop.
You know, or an event, or, you know, fall is coverage.
Right.
Whatever
right.
it is creation. And we all, like, we don't procreate, so we'll procreate in other ways. This is a kind of a neutral, like, place where everybody just kind of goes to have fun, because Halloween is just about being crazy, about having fun and celebrating.
It's the week before Halloween. It's not, it's not the 31st.
www.halloweenyla.com.
You guys are like socialite fundraising angels for the community. That's a pretty good title.
Like that. Coming from you is amazing.
I
love it.
No, you guys do a lot of beautiful stuff, which is beautiful. Yeah. So beautiful, which is so friggin' beautiful. Oh my God, it's so beautiful. It's so beautiful. Oh,
so
it's amazing. It's amazing. And it's amazing. Really, it's amazing, which is so amazing. It must be amazing. Something amazing. Amazing.
And the game
it's amazing.
With...
I love it. I love that. I love that. It was cool. And I love it. I love that. I love it. I love that. I love it. I love it. Loving it. Oh, I love that. Oh, I love it. Yeah. I love that. I love you guys. I want to thank you guys for coming in.
Thank you for having us.
Check out the website. Fred and Jason, thank you so much.
Appreciate it.
For one, doing this for our community and having a great Halloween season. All right, I'm going to use gay powers to whisk you away. You ready?
All
right. Okay, one, two, three, make that noise. Is organic fruit and vegetables better for you? Yes. But this reporter feels like it's just a bitchy, snobby thing that makes people pay for more things and you get more money with things without poison on them. And we need poison. Just ask Cher. Is Instagram taking over Twitter? This reporter says yes. I'm up to 14 followers. Instagram is a wonderful way to connect with people and show them what you've been eating and how much you hate yourself by tagging other people's pictures as yourselves, as we do here in Los Angeles quite often. Are nails just for women anymore? No, they're not. Nail art is making a huge comeback with a new show called Nailed It, where people go in and have magical little crystals put on their fingernails. Is this art? No, it's not. Thanks for tuning in, kids. Please subscribe to my channel. Please check out my website, which is, don't get me started, billyfrancesca.com. The www.'s there, even though I'm trying not to say it, but now I'm making more of a deal about it. And please watch more of my shows, because if you don't, I'm gonna have to get a real job out there in the public sector, and nobody wants that. I can't make change. What does that even mean?